ओम ज्ञानात् तिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा गदा मह्यं ददाति स्वापदान्तिकम्। हे कृष्ण कर्ण सिन्धु दीनबन्धु जगत्पते कान्त राधाकान्त नमस्ते सप्तकाञ्चन गौरङ्गी राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी विषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रियै। न श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधारा शिवसादि गौर भक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। द वीडियो दैट आई जस्ट शोड दैट्स गीतनागरी शिला प्रभुपाद्स फार्म प्रोजेक्ट, वन ऑफ द फार्म प्रोजेक्ट्स अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड। दिस वाज वन इन अमेरिका। ही ओपन्ड मेनी मेनी फार्म कम्युनिटीज टू शो हाउ वी कैन लिव सिंपली। So I'm going to mute the device and then we will start the recording. So I will say most of the things. We have put Les Shlokas, but it's a big chapter. It's basically just a summary of whatever we did all these 17 days. Moksha Sanyas Yoga, perfection of renunciation. This is basically a summary of whatever we did in read in Bhagavad Gita so far. Also, Krishna will give his final word on three modes of material nature. We studied yesterday that the modes are working everywhere. Arjuna inquired about unauthorized worship, that if someone has a faith, but the faith is not written in the scriptures, what is that faith? So Krishna answers that three modes determine faith and worship. Three modes determine what kind of a food we like, what kind of sacrifice and austerities we do, who do we give charity to. And then he gives his verdict that everything should be done for Krishna, with the word Om Tat Sat. And I explained Om means beginning, like unto you Krishna. So beginning of that work has to be given to Krishna. And Tat means performing. So when we are performing, that work also has to be done for Krishna. Sat means objective. So the objective of the work also has to be Krishna. Today, this is the one. Now Krishna is going to revise everything. So freedom from bondage through Karma Yoga. We studied this in third and fifth chapter. It will come again. And it will come in a very, very highly philosophical way in the form of Sankhya Yoga. From verse 1 to 12, Pavanani Manishinam. Then five factors which determine action. Then three modes control everything. Today we are going to discuss more. The three modes are sitting where? In the determination, in the happiness, in the intelligence, so many things. 18 to 40. Then purification through Varnashram Dharma. Okay, we know that we are infected by the mode. Then what to do? Then we have to make a society based on Varna and Ashrama. And why? Because that will lead to the purification. And why do we need a purification? Because without purification, we can't go to Krishna. And Brahman platform, again, revision of the confidential knowledge. And pure bhakti is action in Krishna consciousness. This is the middle six chapters, the nectar. He's going to give final conclusion in the last 10 verses. And then Sanjaya is going to offer prayers in the conclusion. He just can't stop. He'll just go on offering prayers. Okay, Arjuna Uvacha, Sanyasa Yasya Mahabaho Tattvam Ichhami Veditam Tyaga Yasya Chahrishi Kesha Prithak Keshini Sudhana. Arjuna said, oh mighty, I'm one. I wish to understand. This is a very interesting question. We don't ask such question. Arjuna asked it in the middle of a war field. I wish to understand the purpose of renunciation, tyaga, and of the renounced order of life, sannyasa. O killer of Keshi, demon, master of the senses. So purpose of renunciation. Renunciation means that we do an activity, but I give up the result of the activity. So the activity, the action is there. It's just that I'm renouncing, or tyaga means I'm renouncing the fruit of activity. Renounce order of life means I renounce the activity itself. So basically, again, karma yoga or karma sannyasa type of question. Okay, which children are raising hand? This is a big chapter. I will give you chance. Vijita, yes.
Krishna Mataji. Shri Bhagavan Ovacha, Kamyanam Karmanam Nyasam, Sanyasam Kavayo Vidu, Sarva Karma Phala Tyagam, Prahus Tyagam Vichakshanaha.
Very nice. Thank you. So, the Supreme Lord said, to give up the results of all activities is called renunciation or tyaga, and by the wise. And that state is called renounce order of life, sannyasa by great learned men. Okay, so this is what Krishna is explaining the word meaning. Renunciation means give up the activity, and tyaga and renounce order of life means don't do an activity which will lead to karmic reaction, good or bad. So one of the things forbidden in Kali Yuga is sannyas. I was thinking so many days it was going on in the back of my head. If sannyas is prohibited, then how come Prabhupada gives sannyas to so many people? If Prabhupada will never do what's prohibited. How come? So one day I was listening to Prabhupada, and Prabhupada himself spoke about it in the lecture. He said, sannyas is prohibited, but we are not karma sannyasis. We in International Society for Krishna Consciousness, we are not karma sannyasis. We are not karma sannyasis prohibited. Karma sannyas means I know what is my prescribed duty, but I am not going to do it. You know, like big kings went to the forest to meditate, like Bharat Maharaj or King Chitraketu or Dhruva Maharaj. So, but that action is prohibited in Kali Yuga, that I can't just give up my prescribed duty. So what kind of a sannyas was Prabhupada awarding? Prabhupada was awarding the sannyas to work for Krishna. Just work. Stay in the material world. Don't go to the forest, but work. Make this forest of enjoyment into Krishna's place for devotional service. Everyone should become Krishna conscious. So there's a difference in different types of sannyas also. So that sannyas in which one gives up a prescribed duty is prohibited. Some learned men declare that all kinds of fruitive activities should be given up. See, the karma sannyasi matlab means that all kind of activities should be given up. Don't do any activity. Don't breathe. Put a mask on the face. Don't put proper clothes, because clothes are also from touched by karmis. You know, there are sannyasis like that. But there are yet other sages who maintain the acts of sacrifice, charity, and penance should never be abandoned. So Krishna is giving opinions from different places. Some learned men say all kinds of fruitive activities should be given up. Yet other sages say that we should maintain the acts of sacrifice, charity, and penance. Krishna has not yet given his opinion. So this is how we should talk. Okay, whenever you're presenting and answering a question, we must find out the evidence from the Shastras or from whatever papers or whatever. You have to find some evidence, even in the material talks. And then based on those evidences and based on your own understanding, give a conclusion. Okay, who is chanting Advaita Hare Krishna? Yes, unmute yourself.
Hare Krishna. Yajna dana tapaha karma na tyajam karmayam ivatat yajano danam tapaschaiva pavane manisininam.
So much. Yajna dana tapaha karma. So yajna, sacrifice, dana, charity, tapaha, austerity, karma na tyagyam karyam evatat. Na tyagyam should not be given up. Yagno danam tapas chaiva pavani manishinam. So by performing yagna, dana, and tapas, even the most purified men become purified. They become more purified. So act of sacrifice, charity, and penance are not to be given up, but should be performed. Indeed, sacrifice, charity, penance purify even the great souls. So we must never give up. This is Krishna's words. Acts of sacrifice, charity, and penance. The objective of sacrifice, charity, and penance has to be changed. If it was something else other than Krishna, then bring it back to Krishna. but go on doing it. Sacrifice, charity, penance. These are the words of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Does anyone know what pastime is this? Very quickly. What pastime is this? What's happening here?
Basmasura.
Mataji, what did you say, Kalavati Mataji?
This is Basmasura.
This is Daksha. Thank you. This is Daksha. Daksha. Daksha is was the father of, this is in fourth canto Srimad Bhagavatam, father of Mother Sati. So Mother Sati, but he was envious of Lord Shiva, his daughter's husband. He was envious. So he was performing a sacrifice once when he did not invite Mother Sati and Lord Shiva for the sacrifice. Mother Sati saw that people, the denizens of heavenly planets, the women were dressed up very beautifully and they were all talking amongst each other, and the husband and wives, they were all traveling up to go to somewhere. So she asked them, where are you going? They said, Daksha is performing a big sacrifice, so we are going to the sacrificial arena. So she came back to her husband and she said, I want to go to my father's house. Lord Shiva told her not to go because we were insulted the last time you were there and you will not be properly received and I will be insulted, so that will hurt you. He tried to convince her not to go, but she said, I am, that's my dad's house. I don't need any kind of invitation to go to my own father's house. I want to go. So she prepares to go. So Lord Shiva, like a very caring husband, arranges for her to go. Proper paraphernalia. Okay, if you have decided to go, first of all, I don't want you to go, but if you have decided at all, then go properly as my wife, go properly. So he arranges for his servants to go with her, proper gifts that to be given. He arranges everything, but he says, I am not going to go. So she goes, and then of course she was not properly received. Her father ignored her. She used to be the pet child of her father, but her father ignored her. Then she saw that whatever offering spaces were put, there was offering for Lord Vishnu, there was offering for Brahma, but there was no space of offering for Lord Shiva. So she is a chaste wife. So she saw that her husband is completely neglected. So a chaste wife will feel very, very bad if the husband is neglected. So she sits in the middle of the arena and she starts talking to her father in a very, very philosophical way. Goosebumps. You get goosebumps reading Mother Sati's words, that how philosophically elevated she is. And she says that you have not shown proper respect to one of the topmost Vaishnavas. I cannot bear this insult, so I'm going to give up my body. So she gives up her body by chanting the mantras. Just sitting in the arena, she just gives up. And that news goes to Lord Shiva, and Lord Shiva gets angry, not because of a material way that his wife was insulted or is no more, and no one did anything to stop her from committing the suicide. Nobody did. Even her own father, her own mother did not do anything. But it is explained that Lord Shiva gets angry, but not as a material husband will get angry, because now he's missing and lamenting his wife. He gets angry because a Vaishnavi was insulted. So a devotee of Vishnu is insulted, so he gets angry. And commander-in-chief, Lord Shiva's commander-in-chief, is ordered by Lord Shiva to behead Daksha. Just behead him. Doesn't need to live. To pacify him. And then he says, please give back the head of Daksha. So Lord Shiva places the head of a goat on Daksha's head, because he says that he has a goat-like mentality. I'm going to give him a head of a goat. So there, even though he got a head of a goat, he's still performing the sacrifices and he repents and forgives, begs for forgiveness to Lord Shiva. Then Lord Vishnu comes as a proper sacrificial to accept the oblations of the sacrifice. So Prabhupada writes there that one may think that the intelligence of a brain, of a man, is in the brain. You know, why man is different than other people? Because of the brain, the 2-pound matter sitting on the top of the head. This is our intelligence. brain power. But we understand from this incident that Daksha, even though he got the head of a goat, he was still very, very intelligent and did the sacrifice. And he spoke also properly. So we understand that it's not the brain, the matter brain. The intelligence is a function of the soul, which sits in the heart. Okay? Any doctor, neurologist, go back and research. Etani apitu karma. Okay, no. Okay, children, Mahati, go ahead. Mahati, go ahead. I think she's having some problem. Okay, Sumedha, go ahead.
Hare Krishna, ma'am.
Hi, Krishna.
Etani api. Etani api tu tarmani. Sandam taya tatvata. Pahalani ta tarvaniti me partaha nistitam. Mata uttama mam.
Very nice. Thank you. So etani apitu karmani sangam tyakta falani cha karta vyanti me partha nishchitam matam uttamam. All these activities should be performed without expectation of the result. They should be performed as a matter of duty, O son of Pritha. That is my final opinion. So Krishna gives his opinion, three things. Perform without expectation of the result. And first of all, perform them, number one. Second of all, perform them as a without expecting any result. And number three, do it as a matter of duty. Don't think that I have to, I am doing this sacrifice, charity or penance so that I can get a heavenly planet or I can get this. No. We have to change the object of enjoyment. For all these things has to be Krishna. It's a skill. That's why we need a spiritual master. Okay. So some people give up the prescribed duty. So this we made in the table form. Verse number 7, 8, 9. Person in the mode of ignorance will give up the prescribed duties because of the illusion. Person in the mode of passion will also give up the prescribed duty. Why? Because of the difficulties involved in the duty or the fear, whether I will be successful or not. Because it's karmina. So prescribed duty itself, they'll give up. Goodness, person in the mode of goodness will do the prescribed duty as a matter of duty. So these are the different kind of colorful people we have. We can choose, where am I? Ignorance, not do because I'm illusioned. Passion will also not do because of the difficulties involved or fear. Goodness will do because it's a duty. Prabhupada gives a very simple example. Let's say that it is a prescribed duty of every intelligent human being to get up early in the morning and take bath. Early, 1.5 hours before sunrise, get up and do it. So we can see where we are. Goodness, passion or ignorance, that is a prescribed duty. Okay, this is very nice. Oh, mighty Arjuna, learn from me of the five factors which bring about the accomplishment of all actions. So whenever we do action, there are five things which bring about the completion or accomplishment of all action. These are declared in Sankhya Yoga, Sankhya philosophy, to be place of action, the performer, the senses, the endeavor, ultimately the super soul. So we think that I do action and I am the only doer, right? Most of us think like that. Or most of the people across the globe think that I did it. I am the one who did it. But Krishna says there are five things involved in doing any action, any particular action. And what are they? This, the place of action. So let's say that this is the, generally I ask, but I'll tell in this class, place of action. Let's say in this picture, place of action is the market. We need a market place to do shopping. A performer, we need buyer and seller. They both are performers, right? Senses. So unless and until the seller has senses, they can talk, they can hear, or they can see. And same thing for the seller, it has no accomplishment. The endeavor, unless and until somebody endeavored to open a marketplace, to buy, to shop, to sell a shop, to make a shop, to fill up the shop with so many materials, it needs a lot of endeavor, effort. but ultimately Krishna, the super soul. So if Krishna does not sanction, then all these things are not going to happen. So the place of action, the performer, the senses, the endeavor, and ultimately the super soul. Okay, so this is, if I need to make a very big building, then we need a place of action, we need land, we need the performer, so many types of performers, engineer, workers, finance person, architect, so many people. And then we need an endeavor, so they and they must have senses. The performer should have senses, and a performer should also have the endeavor. But ultimately, if Krishna does not sanction, then this is all not going to happen. It's just not going to happen. Therefore, one who thinks himself the only doer, you know, now, from on, now onwards, because now you saw what Krishna wants, or Krishna says that there are five things which are involved in perform in accomplishing an action. After this, if I think that I am the only doer, not considering the five factors, is certainly not very intelligent and cannot see things as they are. So Krishna wants us to become very intelligent, like Sumedha. Sumedha means very intelligent. Medha means intelligent. Sumedha means very, very intelligent. So we all have to have a good brain, right? So knowledge. Now let's talk about this. Knowledge, the object of knowledge and the knower are the three factors which motivate action. What it means is, before we do, this is Sankhya, okay? This is deep analysis. Before we do any action, we do it in the mind. Mind has the function of thinking, feeling, willing. Let's say that yesterday was Dashera and somebody wanted to make jalebi. First, it has to be done in the mind. What are the ingredients needed? Do we have everything in the house? What was the procedure that we used, or look for the recipe? You see, we need to do that in the mind. So that is what it is saying. Motivate action means action which is done in the mind first. What is my motivation behind doing it with my body and senses? The motivation has to be done in the mind. And how is it done in the mind? Go more tuned, fine-tuning knowledge. I need to know how to make a jalebi. Object of knowledge, jalebi. It will come out. Knower, I as a cook, I'm the knower. So these are the three factors which motivate action. Now, after it is done in the mind and I'm already like make my determination that yes, I'm going to do it, I have everything, then what comes into action? The senses, the work itself, and the doer comprise the threefold basis of action. The first part of the verse tells us about the subtle action involved before the real action is done. And the next part of the verse tells us how it is done in the gross sense. Okay, so this is done by one of our students, and he made this basketball. So a basketball player, if he wants to learn, or if he wants to play basketball, he just can't end up in a game. He needs to understand mentally outside the field, even before going for first day. What am I going to do? The knowledge, okay? And then what is the object of knowledge? The game itself. And who is the knower? This person. So that is a subtle action. And once the subtle action is done and it motivates, then person starts doing action with the gross body and senses. This is what it means. Now everybody get a pen and paper again. And you all are going to rate yourself. You don't have to share the results from whatever slides I'm going to show you from now onwards for a long time. Not a long time, but for a relatively, I don't know what to say, relatively, just score yourself. 3 means mode of goodness, that you are in the mode of goodness. 2 means you're in the mode of passion in this particular thing. And 1 means mode of ignorance. Okay, so let's say. This is a big chapter, so we made it like that. 3 kinds of knowledge are based on modes of material nature. So you don't have to share the results, but rate yourself. This is your self-care time, right? So 3 kinds of knowledge based on modes of material nature. That knowledge by which one undivided spiritual nature is seen in all existences, undivided in the divided, is knowledge in the mode of goodness. So I want one of you to explain me. Please raise your hand, but I'll finish this slide first. That knowledge by which different type of living entity is seen to be dwelling in different bodies is knowledge in the mode of passion. And that knowledge by which one is attached to one kind of work as all in all without knowledge of the truth, and which is very meager, is said to be in the mood of darkness. Yes, rate yourself, but tell me, what does it mean? That knowledge, not my co-host. My co-hosts are devotees. You are also devotee. But I want to listen from you. That knowledge by which one undivided spiritual nature is seen in all existences, undivided in the divided, is knowledge in the mode of goodness. So what does this mean? Very quickly, we're not even half done. Yes, Jitesh Prabhu, Hare Krishna. Yes, Prabhuji, what does it mean?
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
As per that verse, as per my understanding, Lord Krishna intends to say that the soul is a part of the super soul and it is present in each and every living being on the, residing on this earth, right from the lowest species till the highest demigod living in the heavenly planet, and treat everybody as an equal because everybody is a soul in the residing in their body.
Very nice.
Okay. Which is part of the manifestation.
Yes. Thank you, Babu. Yes. So, yes, yeah, so he's right. So not the person in the mode of goodness will see one undivided spiritual nature in all existences. So undivided spiritual nature is, they will look at the soul as part and parcel of Krishna. So undivided in the divided, what is divided? The body. We have so many different types of bodies. We have so many children and so many age groups in this classroom. And we have so many adults from so many age groups in this classroom. Everybody's sitting together, different bodies. But what is same in each one of us? The soul. Why is it same? Because it is coming from Krishna. Okay, so that knowledge, one who sees like this is in the mode of goodness. But one who sees the body, oh, this is a child, this is poor, this is rich, this is black, this is white, this is African, American, Indian, Australian, blah and a blah, that is mode of passion. And ignorance cannot see only. They will commit crime, murder, because they don't see. They only see their own self-centered interest. Okay, let's go on. Three kinds of actions on the mode of material nature. As for actions, that action in accordance with the duty, which is performed without attachment, without love or hate, by one who has renounced fruitive results, is called action in the mode of goodness. But that action performed with great effort by seeking to gratify his desires, and which is enacted from a sense of false ego, is called action in the mode of passion. And that action performed in ignorance and delusion without consideration of the future bondage or consequences, which inflicts injury and is impractical, is said to be action in the mode of ignorance. So goodness is we do the duty. I gave example, one Prabhupada gives in second chapter, women's cooking in the summer, hot summer season in India, May to July. He writes it, 2.14 verse. Second chapter, 14th verse in the purport, Prabhupada writes. So, but the woman will still cook, even though it is very, very hot. Why? Because it's a duty. It's a mode of goodness. That duty is burning, is getting out, as long as she's not complaining. And mode of passion is intense desire. Mode of ignorance is terrorism, for example, is one of the examples that comes to my mind. Okay, so workers are in the mode of material nature. Three kinds of workers. I hope you are all writing and rating yourself. The worker who is free from all material attachments and false ego, who is enthusiastic and resolute, who is indifferent to success or failure, is a worker in the mode of goodness. Srila Prabhupada. Actually, he's in Shuddha Sattva, even beyond goodness. But we can understand how much goodness he had. Just do. 70-year-old person traveling for 28 days on a cargo ship, coming to the Western world alone with no money and starting a worldwide movement. You think it's ordinary? That worker who is attached to fruits of his work, fruits of his labor, and who passionately wants to enjoy them, who is greedy, envious, and impure, and moved by happiness and distress, is a worker in mode of passion. Most of the people on earthly planet are like that. We work very hard. Why? Because I want to enjoy. Why? Because I have these impurities in my heart. when we start chanting Hare Krishna, we come face to face with all these impurities. They come in front of us. Krishna reveals that what is my blockers? What are my blockers in going to Krishna? And that worker who is always engaged in work against the injunctions of scriptures, who is materialistic, obstinate, cheating, and expert in insulting others, who is lazy, always morose, and procrastinating, is a worker in the mode of ignorance. So gambler, you know, for example, person who is very addicted to gambling, this will fit in. But we have an element of ignorance, passion, goodness. We are not purely in ignorance. We are not purely in passion. We are not purely in goodness. There is a mixture of all these qualities. We just have to figure out what's maximum in me. And the goal should be to go to goodness at least. Okay, so three kinds of intelligence is based on modes of material nature. O son of Pritha, that understanding by which one knows what ought to be done, what ought not to be done, what is to be feared and what is not to be feared, what is binding and what is liberating, that understanding is established in the mood of goodness. The person understands. That is called, we can introspect. That person can introspect and also can will ask for experiences from other highly elevated persons, not just they don't just act out of impulse. That understanding which cannot distinguish between the religious way of life and the irreligious, between action that should be done and action that should not be done, that imperfect understanding, O son of Pritha, is in the mode of passion. So person wants to, they know what's religious, what's in, what's not not religious, but they cannot act on it. The determination is poor to act on the, because why the determination is poor? Because mode of passion is prominent. Why mode of passion is prominent? Because the faith in Krishna is poor. The faith needs to be worked on. And that understanding which considers irreligion to be religion and religion to be irreligion under the spell of illusion and darkness and strives always in wrong direction, or Pritha, is in the mode of ignorance. Animal sacrifices in the temple for the name of sacrifice, so the god will drink the blood of the poor innocent animal, prohibited in Kali Yuga. That is more of ignorance. That's not a worship. So three kinds of determination based on modes of material nature. So figure out what determination you have. O son of Pritha, that determination which is unbreakable, which is sustained with steadfastness with by yoga practice, and thus controls the mind, life, and the acts of the senses, is in the mode of goodness. So, Vyavasatmika Buddhi Ekehi Kuru Nandana. So, Krishna says in second chapter, right, to Arjuna, that have Vyavasatmika Buddhi, single-minded determination. Single-minded. You should not chop. Bahushakahi Anantasya. Don't chop your intelligence or determination in doing Krishna also, in doing sense gratification also, In cheating also, in gambling also, in intoxicating also. Don't. One, just have one goal. So determination which is unbreakable. And how does it become unbreakable? Because a person in mode of goodness can have a very nice determination in the heart, but the execution of the determination is not just dependent on one's own effort. Then what is it dependent on? Sustained with steadfastness by yoga practice. That person is doing something to keep that determination steadfast and going. And what is it doing? If they're in the mode of goodness, yoga practice. What is the highest yoga? Bhakti yoga. So what are they doing if they are worshipping Krishna? If you see someone worshipping Krishna and defeating all odds, a person cannot understand that how the other person who also has 24 hours can worship Krishna, but I can't. But the person who's doing it can understand how, because it's chanting Hare Krishna. Krishna gives intelligence. Tadami buddhi yogam tvam. 10th chapter, 10th verse. Krishna gives intelligence. You want to come to me? Chant Hare Krishna, I will give you more intelligence, more intelligence. So sustained with steadfastness by yoga practice, thus controls the mind, life, and acts of the senses, is in the mode of goodness. And that determination by which one holds fast to fruitive result in religion, economic development, and sense gratification, is of the mode of passion, nature of passion, O Arjuna. So many people are doing dharma or religious sacrifices. Why? To to get artha. So dharma artha, then kama, to do sense gratification. Artha means money. So do a religious activity. You know, people go to temples across the world, church or whatever. They go to Krishna or a demigod or anybody of their faith. Why? Because they want something. Oh God, give me my daily bread. Oh God, make me successful. Oh God, give me job. Oh God, give me good result. Oh God, bring easy examination paper. That is passion. Okay. And that determination, which cannot go beyond dreaming, fearfulness, lamentation, moroseness, and illusion. Such unintelligent determination is in the mode of darkness. That person cannot come out of the cannot come out of the fear factor. Why there is a fear? Because there are so many dreams. So what happens? What we say, dreaming is powerful. Dream and then you will achieve. No. Because by dreaming, Prahlad Maharaj says in 7th canto Srimad Bhagavatam, this is so interesting, that the minute, when does the miserable life of a person start? When does it start? The minute we start thinking of sense gratification. It starts at the same time that the minute I start thinking that I'm going to enjoy my life like this, miserable condition starts. Why? Because they're not enjoying at present. Okay, then they enjoy for that particular moment, whatever they want to do, but then they come back to the miserable condition. I give example of going to movie. Guru Maharaj gives this example. Let's say somebody is planning that I'm going to go and watch this movie on this Friday or Saturday, or you know, whatever. This weekend, we are going to see this movie in the theater. Oh my God, that means whole week is spent accumulating and thinking, I'm going to do it. That means that they're so miserable and anxious to do it. Chalo, we go to the hall, the movie or theater. Then buy some popcorns, buy some, soft drinks. Sit down, watch movie. Whatever time duration was there, it's done. Now come back again. When will I go again? Again, the misery starts. When will I go? Happiness means that I'm very happy where I am. Movie, no movie, or actually no movie. You don't even want movie. But very happy minute to minute. Not like I have something in future which will give me happiness. That is mode of darkness. Mode of darkness. It's unintelligent happiness, determination. Okay, or drunkards, people who are addicted to alcohol, that they're determined they're going to do it, or smoking cigarette, any addiction for that matter. They're determined. It needs determination to do an action. So that determination, which is leading them to intoxication and cloudiness of the memory, that's ignorance. Now, happiness, based on that determination and action, we define whether we are happy or not. So happiness in the mode of nature. That which is beginning, which in the beginning may be just like poison, but at the end is just like nectar, and which awakens one to self-realization, is said to be happiness in the mode of goodness. That happiness which is derived from contact of senses with their objects, and which appear like nectar at first, but poison at end, is said to be in the mode of, is of the nature of passion. And that happiness which is blind to self-realization, which is delusion from beginning to end, which arises from sleep, laziness, and illusion, is said to be of the nature of ignorance. So happiness, which is pain in the beginning, effort, which is pain in the beginning, but nectar at the end, is mode of goodness. Sorry, so chanting 16 rounds could be painful in the beginning, but later it becomes a part of the life. So which in the beginning may be just like poison, but at the end is just like nectar. This is Krishna consciousness for some of us. Actually, Krishna consciousness, there is no poison, but the effort involved, get up at 4:30 in the morning, chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, eat only Krishna Prasadam, no restaurants, no movies. Oh, ho, I have to give up so much. No coffee, no tea. Oh, how will I live? So that could be poisonous for someone. But then after practicing, associating with devotees, tasting the nectar, then it's okay. What was I doing? Okay, and then happiness in the mode of passion is, we studied in 5th chapter, I showed you the diagram where animal kingdom, one sense is very strong and the moth after a rainfall. So many moths are flying towards a very hot lamp, right? Remember, because they have a vision, the vision sense is very strong. So they are meeting their sense of vision with the object of the sense, which is the light. And they're running towards it to taste it. But what happens? They die because they come in touch with the hot bulb. So that happiness, which is derived from the contact of senses with the object, I mean, which appears to be like a nectar at the first, but poison at the end because it kills, is said to be of the nature of passion. And that happiness, which is blind to self-realization. You know, people, some people or somebody who likes to sleep 30 hours out of 24 hours, they are happy. If you go and wake them up, that get up, so much hour you have sleeping, why are you in coma or what? Get up, you have so much work to do. But they'll just pull up their sheet and they say, I am enjoying it. So they enjoy, but the other person in the higher mode can see, arre yaar, sleep, laziness, illusion. What are you doing? Wasting your life. If I sleep that much, I'll get a headache. Get up. But no, they are enjoying. So that happiness. Okay, you can rate. What is your rating? Okay, so I'm just going to revise with some of the slides of whatever I said. Jitesh Prabhu answered is very nicely. The knowledge by which one undivided spiritual nature is seen in all living entities, though they are divided into innumerable forms, you should understand to be in the mood of goodness. Simple, the Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma or a humble sage will see the same spiritual spark everywhere, whether it's animal body or dog body, or whatever body, or a human body, baby body, woman body, demigod body, same soul, same. And this determination, I was talking about Prabhupada, which is unbreakable, which is sustained with steadfastness by yoga practice, which thus controls the activities of mind, life, and senses, is determination in the mode of goodness. Srila Prabhupada's minute to minute was nothing but filled with Krishna consciousness. Now, it is amazing how we can have 24 hours in a day and they also fall short. Why? Because there's so much to do with Krishna. People think Krishna consciousness is armchair philosophy. And here is our Acharya, who was thinking even 24 hours or less. Sometimes you're giving discourses to the public, sometimes giving discourses to very prominent people in the society. Sometimes all night, Srila Prabhupada used to translate books all night. Hardly he used to sleep 1.5 hours. I heard Prabhupada's servant, Shutakirti Prabhu. Shutakirti Prabhu was traveling with Prabhupada during the last years across the globe. And he was giving the class and he was telling Prabhupada's schedule was same anywhere he went across the globe, any time zone. Same. It's amazing. And Prabhu went on telling so many things about Prabhupada. Prabhupada used to sleep 1.5 hour, 2 hour at the max. And then he used to get up and every day he used to say, sleeping is waste of time. I wish I can not sleep. How many of us can say that? Okay, the four kinds of ashramas are also based on the modes of material nature. Shamo, tamas, tapaha. So these are the 9 qualities of a brahmana. Not like my father is a brahmana, so I'm automatically a brahmana. No. Check if you have these qualities. Shamo, tamas, tapaha, saucham, shantir, ajavam, evacha, jnanam, vijnanam, astikyam, brahma, karma, subhavajam. Peacefulness, self-control, austerity, purity, tolerance, honesty, wisdom, knowledge, and religiousness are the qualities by which a brahmana works. So self-check. Do I have these? No. Then do I have these? Do I have these? Something will be there. Then I'm not a brahmana. And that's fine. Acceptance is very important. I always say there are 5 ways in running any relationship, including the relationship with oneself. What are the 5 ways? Let me see. Does anyone remember, any of my co-hosts, what are the 5 ways of a successful relationship? Sumedha, don't type so much. my co-host? Okay, I will try to say. One is acceptance. Accept. Okay, we are talking about relationship with oneself. So accept what you are. Look at the qualities and see. Have full acceptance of who you are or what you are psychologically, physically. with if I'm always finding fault, oh, my nose is like this, my eyes are like this, my character is like this. Oh my God, how much you have to procrastinate? Krishna gave you these. If I'm insulting myself indirectly, I'm not happy with Krishna's decision. Something is non-changeable, right? A color of the eye, what are you going to do? It is what it is. But accept it. And then appreciate that Krishna gave intelligence. He gave human form of life. Do you think that we deserve this? Srila Prabhupada gave this all. What have we done? So acceptance, appreciation, and then attention. Pay attention to what your feelings are, what your needs are. And then acceptance, appreciation, attention, affection, and alliance. Affection. Have affection. Okay, I'm going to introspect and I'm going to set an intention. That is a sign of self-affection. And then alliance means give yourself some space to work. Just don't fill up the space with self-criticism. Allow yourself some space. So Krishna consciousness is so nice. We learn all these things. Then Shauryam, Tejo, Dhritir, Dakshyam, Yuddhe, Chapi, Apalayanam, Danam, Ishvara, Bhavascha, Kshatram, Karma, Subhavajam. Heroism, power. These seven qualities define who is a Kshatriya. Heroism, power, determination, resourcefulness, courage in battle, generosity and leadership are the qualities of work for Kshatriya. Not that, okay, I have Kshatriya kind of a feeling. I'm such a good fighter. No, no, no. Do you have these seven qualities? No, then you're not a Kshatriya. Or I am not a Kshatriya. Krishi go raksha vanijyam vaishya karma subhavajam. So these three qualities. Krishi go raksha. Krishi means agriculture. And go raksha means protecting the cows. Vanijyam means banking or business. Vaishya karma subhavajam. Paricharya atmakam karma. Sudrashyapi subhavajam. Farming, cattle raising, and business are the qualities of work for the Vaishyas. And Shudras have one quality. What is it? That the labor and service to others. But we should not worry. You know why? Because Srimad Bhagavatam says, Kalo Shudra Sambhavaha. In Kali Yuga, everybody is born as a Shudra. Nobody is born as Brahmana. Let's be realistic. Vyasadeva is saying it. Why? Because unless and until most of the mentality is, unless and until I do some service, I have a job, I cannot live. Because the whole aim of going through big trainings, educational institutes in today's world is to have a job. So that is the Shudra mentality. So Brahmana will have nine qualities, Kshatriya has seven qualities, and Vaishya has three qualities, and Shudra has one quality, but they are all important. It's not that we're going to ignore them. They're compared to the body. So the head is compared to the Brahmanas in a body. Hands are compared to the Kshatriyas. I think the thighs are the Vaishyas and the legs are the Shudras. I used to think bellies, but Prabhupada says thighs. Okay, I'll give chance. Mahati, unmute yourself. Vijita, you want to chant the verse? That's why you're raising your hand.
सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवः.
Thank you so much. By worship of the Lord, one who is the source of all beings and who is all pervading, man can, in performance of his own duty, attain perfection. This is revolutionary. Bhagavad Gita is revolutionary in one's life. Why? Because Krishna is saying, you don't have to necessarily become a Brahmana. Just worship me. Worship to whatever varna and ashrama you are in. Just put me in your life and you can attain me. Attain the perfection in your own duty and also attain Krishna at the end. Who doesn't want to lead a life like this? Every one of us should be aspiring. So Brahmana can be a perfect Brahmana and talk about Krishna. Kshatriya, Arjuna is a Kshatriya. He's not a Brahmana. He's not a Vaishya. He's not a Shudra. He's a Kshatriya. And he's worshipping Krishna by checking what Krishna wants. And Vaishya, by cultivating agriculture, by cow protection. I showed you all the video of Gita Nagari that is based on the Vaishya cult. Prabhupada wanted to prove to the world that Varnashrama system can be re-established. And Shudras are on the service to the others. We need some people who can help us, right? Why don't neglect them? They can also help us, and we can also engage them in a way that the result can go to Krishna. So everybody will become happy. This is, I don't know what's happening to Mahati. Your hand is raised. I keep on asking you, unmute.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Hello.
Yes, Mahati, please go ahead.
Shreyan Swadharmo Vigunaha Paradharmatva Anushyatita Svabhavaniyatam Karma Kurvanapnoti Kilbisham.
Thank you so much. It is better to engage in one's own occupation, even though one may perform it imperfectly, than to accept another's occupation and perform it perfectly. Prescribed duties according to one's nature are never affected by sinful reaction. Don't try to copy. If I go and try to copy Srila Prabhupada, I am dead. Prabhupada was traveling every 3 to 5 days. He was traveling. Live like him. No. I can recognize what I am good at, what skill Krishna gave me. So they said this painting, let's analyze this picture. So there is this person and there is this tree and he has a collection of these participants. And he's telling them, first to climb the tree will win. And the dog is thinking he's gone nuts. Seal is thinking, I think he needs glasses. Fish is thinking he wants to kill me. And the elephant is thinking, climb the tree. I will only break the tree. I cannot climb because I have so much strength that I will just break the tree. And the penguin is thinking he needs some antipsychotics. He needs some medication. He's not looking at that I'm seal. Only two people are happy, two animals. Who are they? Monkey and crow. Yes, we are going to compete and we are going to climb the tree. But that doesn't mean that all these animals don't have any ability. This person is foolish. He doesn't know how to engage them. So let's not do that. We are all needed in service to Krishna. Each one of us are needed in service to Krishna. And we all can contribute in our own effort. Every single one. One can obtain the results of renunciation simply by self-control and becoming unattached to material things and disregarding material enjoyment. This is the highest perfectional stage of renunciation. So I don't have to dress up like a sannyasi or take sannyas or travel like Srila Prabhupada. That's the highest order. It's an unmatchable. We can't copy. But what should I do? Should I get discouraged? Should I sit in a corner? Should I think that, oh my God, my life is useless. Why am I even living? No. Krishna is saying, no. Simply self-control and becoming unattached to material things. Acha, how can I become unattached to material things? How? By having a higher taste. Param Dishtva Nivartate. Because a person in Krishna consciousness will develop a higher taste. So a lower taste, going to restaurant, oh my God, immediately the thing comes in the stomach. That food, no. That is not offered to Krishna. It's not tasty. So how do we get that? By tasting Krishna's prasadam. Unless and until someone has tasted Krishna prasadam, they will not be able to give up. They will not be able to give up. The mind will put some argument in the front, but you are hungry. You didn't have time to cook, but you deserve some relaxation. Why do you have to follow all these things? No. Person in Krishna consciousness will say that food was more tasty. This food doesn't taste nice because there's something missing. Krishna factor is missing. So that Krishna will give the higher taste. Just chant Hare Krishna, the sound vibration will change the mind. Okay, Vijita. Yes, go ahead.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Okay. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Na Sochati Na Kanksati Sama Sarveshu Bhuteshu Mad Bhaktim Labhate Param.
Very nice. Thank you so much. So one who is transcendently situated at once realizes the Supreme Brahman. He never laments nor desires to have anything. He is equally disposed to every living entity. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me. So the pure devotional state is this, and we all can get it by Krishna's mercy, by Srila Prabhupada's mercy, by the mercy of Acharyas. They are very merciful. Vaishnavas are the ocean of mercy. How many things can we get from ocean? So many. Will the ocean ever fall short of those things? No. Why? Because it's so deep in itself. So Vaishnavas are Kripa Sindhu. Sindhu means ocean and Kripa means mercy. So they are full of mercy. So take mercy from the Vaishnavas because they want to give it. Take it. Don't say, oh, no, I don't need it. We need it very badly. Actually, we pray that please give me the mercy first. Why? Because I'm the lowest. I'm the lowest. I don't have any understanding. Who am I? Who is Krishna? So that particular living entity who is Brahma Bhuta, is at once realizes the Supreme Brahman. Does not need to go through 12-year, 50-year or 20-year of training at once. Never laments, nor desires to have anything. Equally disposed. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me. Prabhupada made so many drunkards, so many people with so many abominable activities, topmost devotees of Krishna. He gave sannyas order, Goswami, because they met the eligibility criteria. Why? Because they associated with him. Bhaktya mam abhijanati yavan yaschashmi tatvataha tato mam tatvo gyatva vishate tad anantaram. One can understand the Supreme Personality as he is only by devotional service. When he is in full consciousness of the Supreme Lord, by such devotion, he can enter into the kingdom of God. So don't try to understand Krishna by speculation, by philosophy, or by self-intelligence, or by the mind game, or by tark vitark, by arguments and logic. Krishna cannot be understood by those things. How? Engage in devotional service. Devotional service is so powerful that it actually can lead us back to Krishna's kingdom, back there. And this is the life there. All the women are very, very... This is described in Srimad Bhagavatam. Okay, it's almost time, but I need another 15, 20 minutes. So please bear with me. That all the women in Vaikuntha are very, very beautiful. In this world, we see that some women may look beautiful more than the other. They all are beautiful, but some may look apparently to these materialized. But there, everybody is perfect. No one is having any bodily defects. How did they get there? How? Did they go to Zumba class or fitness or gym? Or they had a personal trainer? No. Krishna decorated them because they're devotees. Krishna decorates a devotee. Okay, so sarva karmani api sada kurvan mad vyapashriyaha. Mat prasadad avapnoti shashvatam padam avyayam. Though engaged in all kinds of activities, my devotee under my protection reaches the eternal and imperishable abode by my grace. So Krishna makes sure that even though I'm doing everything imperfectly, but because I'm doing an effort, Krishna will make sure. And these are the this is the result of becoming Krishna conscious. Mat chitta sarva durgani mat prasada tarishyasi atha chetvam ahankaram nashroshyasi vinankashi. If you become conscious of me, you will pass over all the obstacles of conditional life by my grace. If, however, you do not work in such consciousness but act through false ego, not hearing me, you will be lost. So Krishna is giving his final word to Arjuna. He's not forcing. Ishvara sarvabhuta nam hridyeshi arjuna tishtati brahmayan sarvabhutani yantra rudrani mayaya. The supreme lord is situated in everyone's heart, O Arjuna, and is directing the wanderings of all living entities who are seated as though on a machine made of material energy. Living entity is spiritual soul, but right now is seated on a body, a machine. Body is compared to yantra here. What is this yantra made of? Steel or gasoline or different kinds of oils? No. This yantra is made of the products which are supplied by material nature. So the body is made of things which material nature gives, and I, the spirit soul, is sitting in the body and moving it there. When I, the spirit soul, leaves the body, this body is again dead. Actually, it is dead. The nature of the body is to decay. One sannyasi was analyzing. The nature of the body is decay. Why? If I don't brush my teeth, the natural tendency is to just rot. If I don't comb my hair, the natural tendency is to become locky, dirty. If I don't take my bath, the natural tendency is to accumulate dirt. I, because I'm present in the body as a soul, I take care. That why it appears that it's living, it's changing, but actually nothing is happening. Yes, Vijita, you look desperate to say yes.
Go Hare on. Krishna Mataji. Tam eva saranam gacha sarva bhavena bharata tat prasadat param santim sthanam prapshyasi shashvatam.
Thank you. O Saina Bharata, surrender unto him utterly. By his grace, you will attain transcendental peace and the supreme and eternal abode. Who will not surrender? We all should surrender, okay? Because there's so much happiness waiting. Krishna is waiting. Prasadam is waiting. Devotees are waiting. Iti te jnanam akhyatam guhyat guhyataram maya vimshrayeda asheshena yathechasi tatha kuru. Thus, I have explained to you the most confidential of all knowledge. Deliberate on this fully and then do what you wish to do. Yathechasi tatha kuru. Krishna is still not forcing Arjuna to fight. He's still giving him the option. And that is the best relationship where there is no force. Arjuna vacha nashto moho smritir labdha tvat prasadan mayachyuta stitho asmi gata sandeha karishyasi vachanam dava. Arjuna said, my dear Krishna, O infallible one, my illusion is now gone. I have regained my memory by your mercy and I am now firm and free from doubt and I am prepared to act according to your instructions. This is the first time Arjuna is saying that I am prepared to act according to your instructions. He has said, 9th chapter, my illusion is over. 10th chapter, also my illusion is over. 11th chapter, also he said, my illusion is over. But what is now the special addition to his sentence? I am now firm and free from doubt and prepared to act according to your instructions. So completely now I'm going to do it. Krishna says, do these 4 things, you're coming to me. And these are our deities, Radha Govinda. Man mana bhava mad bhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru mam evashyasi satyam te prati jane priyo asmi me. Always think of me and become my devotee. Worship me. Offer your homage unto me. Thus you will come to me without fail. I promise you this because you are my very dear friend. So what are the 4 things? Think of Krishna always and become his devotee. Worship Krishna and offer homage. 4 things you do. Go to Krishna. Sarvadharman parityajya mam ekam sharanam vraja aham tam sarva papebhyo mokshishyami ma sucha. Abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender unto me. I shall deliver you from all sinful reactions. Do not fear. Oh my God, I was leading so sinful life. How can I go to Krishna? Do it right now. And Krishna will take care. Idam te nata pakshya nabhaktaya kadachana na cha shushurve vachyam na cha mam yo abhyashuyati. This confidential knowledge may not be explained to those who are not austere or devoted or engaged in devotional service, nor to one who is envious of me. So we should not be talking Bhagavad Gita to such people, but a devotee takes chance. For one who explains the supreme secret to devotees, devotional service is guaranteed. So go preach Krishna consciousness to your nears and dears or to the whole world. Why? Because Krishna will give you more and more devotional service. And at the end, he will come back to me. So I'm making my own route back clear. So there is no servant in this world more dear to me than he, nor will there ever be one more dear. So Srila Prabhupada, we must pay our respects to Prabhupada every day. Thank you, Prabhupada, for giving this. Because if Prabhupada did not take the effort, we didn't get it. And imagine how much dear he is to Krishna. Very dear. Then I declare that he who studies this sacred conversation worships me by his intelligence. Shraddhavan anasuyascha shrunuyad api yo naraha. So api mukta sobha lokan prapar niyutayat punya karmanam. And one who listens with faith and without envy becomes free from sinful reaction and attains to the planets where the pious dwell. To all the listeners who are listening without envy, get this benediction. Now Sanjaya offers, these are our last few prayers. Sanjaya said, thus I have heard the conversation of 2 great souls, Krishna and Arjuna. And so wonderful is that message that my hair is standing on end. By the mercy of Vyasa, I have heard these most confidential talks directly from the master of the mysticism, Krishna, who was speaking personally to me. O King, as I repeatedly recall this wondrous and holy dialogue between Krishna and Arjuna, I take pleasure being thrilled at every moment. O King, when I remember the wonderful form of Lord Krishna, I am struck with even greater wonder and I rejoice again and again. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna, Yatra Partho Dhanurdhara, Tatra Shir Vijayo Bhutir, Dhruva Nitir Matir Mama. Wherever there is Krishna, the master of all mystics, and wherever there is Arjuna, the supreme archer, there will also certainly be opulence, victory, extraordinary power and morality. That is my opinion. Don't think going to Krishna you're at loss. Biggest gain. So this was the chapter. I still have some things to show. I want to know the Gita Mahatmya, show the Gita Mahatmya to give you the benediction of going through this for 18 days. So freedom from bondage to karma. Then five factors of action we discussed. Then we discussed three modes controlling so many other things. And we discussed that how we can be engaged in our own occupational duty and attain perfection. And this is the most confidential knowledge that Krishna explained to Arjuna. And pure bhakti is the four things. Man mana bhava bhakto bhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru. Or sarva dharman parityaja. Leave everything that we are doing and just surrender. So this is a very nice prayer from Chaitanya Chaitamrita, Madhya Leela, chapter 7, verse 96. Mahaprabhu used to chant this in front of Jagannath, Lord Jagannath. If we chant, we also get a lot of benediction. It's very simple. Krishna, 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 hey. Krishna, 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 hey. Krishna, 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 Raksha Mam. Krishna, 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 Pahi Mam. Ram, Raghav, Ram, Raghav, Ram, Raghav, Raksha Mam. Krishna, Keshav, Krishna, Keshav, Krishna, Keshav, Pahi Mam. How hard is it? Not hard at all. So you can also chant Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Prabhupada said, our process is to show Krishna consciousness as it is, not as others want to see it. So present it as it is. You all can have an opportunity to serve Shri Radha Govinda by giving either the artha or give your time or give your voice or give your skill in service of Krishna. So this is the donation links. I will share again today if you would like to donate to the service of Radha Govinda. And this was all based on the teachings of Srila Prabhupada, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Abhay Charanara, Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, founder Acharya of International Society for Krishna Consciousness. And these are our darling duties, the deities, Shri Radha Govinda, for whose pleasure we did everything and with whose pleasure we culminate today. So Om Tat Sat. Okay. Okay, so if anyone has any, once again, I will, maybe I should make breakout rooms. Should I make breakout rooms for 5 minutes and then bring everyone back?
Mataji.
Okay.
Mataji, you said you were going to show Gita Mahatmaya. Would be this be before or after?
No. Thank you so much. Oh, Krishna. Thank you so much. Yes, we must see Gita Mahatmya in the beginning and at the end. Thank you so much for reminding. Oh, my God. So, yes, this was sung by my friend. She's a devotee. She's taking Kannada classes.
Atha Gita Mahatmya. Gita Shastram Idam Punyam. Ya Pate Trayata Puman. Vishnu Padam Avapnoti. Bhaya Shoka Divarjita. Gita Dhyayana Shilasya. Pranayama Parasya Cha. Naiva Santi Hi Papani. Purva Janma Kritani Cha. Mala Nirmochanam Pumsa. Jalasnanam Dini Dini. Sakrit Gitam Bhasi Snanam. Samsara Malanashanam. Gita Sugita Kartavya. Kimmanye Shastra Vistare. Yasvayam Padmanabhasya. Mukha Padmadini Shruta. Bharata Amrita Sarvasvam. Vishnur Vaktra Dvinisritam. Gita Gangodakam Pitva. सर्वोपनिषदो गावो दुग्धा गोपाल नंदना पार्थो वत्सा सुधीर्भोक्ता दुग्धं गीतामृतं महात् एकं शास्त्रं देवकी पुत्र गीतं एको देवो देवकी पुत्र एवा एको मंत्रस्तस्य नामानि यानि कर्मापीकं तस्य देवस्य सेवा.
One who with regulated mind recites with devotion this Bhagavad Gita scripture, which is the bestower of all virtue, will attain to a holy abode such as Vaikuntha, the residence of Lord Vishnu, which is always free from the mundane qualities based on fear and lamentation. Maybe Vishita can read it. Vishita, can you read it?
Thank you. If one reads Bhagavad Gita very sincerely and with all seriousness, then by the grace of the Lord, the reactions of his past misdeeds will not act upon him. One may cleanse himself daily by taking a bath in water, but if one takes a bath even once in the sacred Ganges water of Bhagavad Gita, for him the dirt of material life is altogether vanquished. Because Bhagavad Gita is spoken by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one need not read any other Vedic literature. One need only attentively and regularly hear and read the Bhagavad Gita. In the present age, people are so absorbed in mundane activities that it is not possible for them to read all the Vedic literatures. But this is not necessary. This one book, Bhagavad Gita, will suffice because it is the essence of all Vedic literatures, and especially because it is spoken by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. By drinking the Ganges water of the Gita, the divine quintessence of the Mahabharata emanating from the holy lotus mouth of Lord Vishnu, one will never take rebirth in the material world again. In other words, by devotionally reciting the Gita, the cycle of birth and death is terminated. All the Upanishads are like a cow, and the milker of the cow is Lord Shri Krishna, the son of Nanda. Arjuna is the calf, the beautiful nectar of the Gita is the milk, and the fortunate devotees of the fine theist intellect are the drinkers and the enjoyers of that milk. There need be only one holy scripture, the divine Gita, sung by Lord Shri Krishna. Only one worshipable Lord Shri Krishna, only one mantra, his holy names, and only one duty, devotional service unto that supreme worshipable Lord, Shri Krishna.
Thank you so much. So I thank each one of you for attending this. I'm sorry if I did any mistake. I was sincerely just trying. And in the trial period, there can be so many mistakes. I'm not a Mahabhagavata. So thank you each. Please become Krishna conscious. Please chant Hare Krishna and please become very happy. And at the end of the life, go back to Krishna. Yes, Prabhu, what were you going
to say? Yes. Yeah, just small thing. Like Aishwarya Mataji, she wants to join and make an announcement for the new class. She asked to check with you if it is fine towards the end of your class.
Who is?
Aishwarya Mataji. She wanted to make announcement for the next batch. So she just asked to check with you if she can join your class now.
Yeah, please. Yeah, just right. Yeah, is she here now?
No, she asked your permission. After that, she will join. Yeah.
Call her. Okay, I'll call her, but I'll make the breakout room. So Roshan,
yes, Mataji.
Mataji and Kalavati Mataji, please check on each other. And 5 minutes, I'll call you back because.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay. So whoever is staying back, we can talk for some time. And then Aishwarya wants to say something. I will allow, please, whoever, you can raise your hand or unmute. But when you unmute, please tell me your name and let's not go over each other.
Yes. Mataji, still we are here? No breakout room?
I made the rooms.
I didn't open the room.
You have to make the room and open the room also. So I didn't press the button to open the room. Nirupa Mataji, I was looking for you. I think you came a little late. I always make you a co-host. Yes, I'm a Sundaram Prabhu. Yes, Prabhuji, please unmute yourself. NS Sundaram Prabhu or Dyuti Mataji. By the way, you all have permission to. Yes,
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Mataji, I just wanted to know that, you know, as there is corona all over, even in Kolkata, and as I have a small child, so I can't go at the temple and collect, you know, the Japamala, because I really want to start, you know, doing the Japamala and chanting Hare Krishna. So Mataji, from where can I get, the Japamala of Hare Krishna from any particular site? And is there any auspicious day from when I can start chanting? If you can clarify, please, Mataji.
Yes. So you can get the Japamala from our website, actually. I'm going to take you there. Okay. So.
Okay, Mataji.
Whole course material. 1 second. Give me a minute.
Mataji, I can forward if you want. Like.
Please forward. So, Mataji, Dyuti Mataji, go to the ISKCON Mangalore.
Okay. Okay, Mataji.
Gita in 18. Batch 2, you see this, where is the course material? This is the course, so we're charging 600 rupees, including shipping anywhere in India. This
Okay, Mataji. Thank you so much, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Mills today. Yes, Hare Krishna. Thank you. NS Sundaram Prabhu. Prabhuji.
Namaste, madam. First, let me thank you profoundly for introducing me to Bhagavad Gita. Okay. My question is, see, like, ultimately Krishna says sarva dharma parityajya. Okay, that means give everything and surrender to me. That appears to be the most easiest thing of all. Okay, he could have said it at the first. Why did he keep it to the last?
Because what he wants to say many times, actually. Give your mind to me. For me, so many places he's saying it. The final word he said, and do not, that's different, but he's from the first he spoke. When he's second chapter said, Sita Dhiri, he's explaining, I think, verse 4 to 72, something like that, in second chapter. He's explaining the person, transcendental consciousness, means that the consciousness, third chapter, Karma Yoga. Chapter, he's saying it, you know, giving in the aid. Okay,
Hare Krishna Mataji, your voice is breaking a lot.
Yes, today I could not hear much. I'll have to listen to the recording. That's what I also thought.
Your voice is breaking, Mataji, for me also. Actually. I don't know why,
Mataji. Actually, there is some background noise.
But was my voice breaking in class?
Yeah, no, not throughout the class, but right now it was breaking.
After the breakup room has started, it's breaking.
That is because
you need to put everyone on mute.
So I'm going to unmute everyone and then it will not break because too many people turn on their mics at the same time. Okay, Nirupama Mataji, you had a question?
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Actually, we both are today in one place, so we are hearing in from his connection. So I joined separately now with Dr. Padhi. I was hearing your lecture throughout. I want to ask that what is the significance of Tilaka that you are using, and is it necessary for everybody, or what is this advantage significance? I want to know.
Yes, so you are a doctor, right, Mataji? So yes. When you go to the hospital or work, you have an ID badge or you have a stethoscope around your neck and you have a apron, a white coat. What is the need? Because people should know who's a doctor, who's not a doctor, right? So like that, we put the tilaka because it tells that, okay, there comes a devotee of Krishna. That's one reason why we have to have the marks. And I will give you one more punchline. Prabhupada said, like, we have this Kanti beads, the neck beads, the Tulsi. What is the need? God is in the heart. But Prabhupada was asked this question in the Western world, and Prabhupada knew that they may not understand the proper thing. So Prabhupada gave the answer. You asked me about the Tilika, so let me complete that first. First is that you should look at a devotee of Krishna. Immediately when they will look at Krishna, devotee of Krishna, they will think of Krishna. So the thinking of Krishna is incited, even in a critical manner. But that is punya. It's pious. Person is becoming pious. And the other is that our Tilika, the Vaishnava Sampradaya, the body is a temple. And there are 12 places where we mark the tilak, not just on the forehead. There are 12 places because we decorate the temple, right, Mataji?
Yes. In your yes. House.
So like that, we decorate the body in because Lord is sitting inside. And also the tilaka, this means that there are two limbs, Krishna's two legs, and the tulsi at the lotus feet. So that's the meaning of the tilak in Brahma Vaishnava Gaudiya Sampradaya. Okay, but Kanti being Prabhupada was asked, why do you wear Kanti? And that too, like neck hugging, like so close to neck, why can't it be hanging? Yes. Prabhupada answered, should I tell you?
Yes.
So Prabhupada, yes, have you ever seen a pet dog? How do you know that this is a pet dog? A pet dog, you will know because a pet dog will have a leash, like a leash around the neck. That's a collar. A stray dog will not have any collar. Why? Because stray dog doesn't have a master, but the pet dog has a collar. That's how we distinguish. So we say why there is a leash or why there is a collar? Because the master pulls the dog from that collar or from that leash attached to the collar. Like that, when you look at the Kanti beads in my neck, you know I have a master and I am the pet dog of a master and my master is Vishnu. Prabhupada mm-hmm. said that.
Very nice, Mataji. Thank you.
I never hesitated to wear Kanti. I used to hesitate wearing beads in the public, especially in America. But after I heard this, I said, forget it. I'm a pet dog of Krishna. So,
very nice. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you, Hare Krishna. Yes, Lata Mataji. So I'm bringing everyone back. Aishwarya, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Aishwarya, just everyone is joining back and then I will get
yes, you. Yes, Mataji. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Mataji, I have a doubt.
Yes, Mataji.
Mataji, can we wear our Kanti Mala during the periods?
Yes, that's why it has to be neck hugging. No, it cannot be hanging down so we can touch with... Anyway, actually for anybody, because we should not be touching Kanti beads with the dirty hands. So just get it close to the neck. Yes. Yes, Prabhupada said.
Mataji, where can we get that beads? That?
So we are trying to get it on the temple website. In Corona time, you can get it from our temple website. But after the Corona is over, the nearest temple to your house will always have it.
Okay. And also, can we use any Japamala to like chant Hare Krishna, or is it some particular Japamala?
Whatever you have, because the world, the situation is like that, whatever you have is fine for now. Initially, if you're someone is not chanting 16 rounds, then it is recommended to chant on the neem beads. But once you catch up to 16 rounds, definitely tulsi beads.
Right now, I have started chanting Hare Krishna for just one round, 108 times a day. So I chant it like this only. Like I can, I use my fingers, these fingers, 8 times.
Very nice. You're so determined. So you don't have any chanting beads, any
no.
type.
No.
Then make one. You get big. You make neck necklace. Now my daughter makes. Jewelry. So she was making yesterday. So then you get big jewelry. I don't know what you call beads, big beads. Get
yes,
it?
Yes.
Mataji, initially with tulsi bead, any problem?
No, there's no problem. No, there shouldn't be a problem. It's a recommendation. It's not fixed.
So first neem bead, followed by tulsi bead.
Neem beads, you can do on tulsi beads directly if someone is chanting 16 rounds following the...
Mataji, but there are regulations of using tulsi beads, right?
Yes, but then it's fine because Namanishta Prabhu gave us all tulsi beads from the get-go. Mataji, my Guru Maharaj was asked one time, that there are so many regulations. Actually, we say four regulatory principles, but actually there are 64 regulatory principles, not just four. But my Guru Maharaj was asked about to explain each and every one of them. And he was in London, Bhaktivedanta Manor, and he was giving class there. And one devotee asked that we should not pay obeisances to the deities when there is food offering going on or when the altar is closed and they are resting. Even if you enter the temple, we should not pay obeisances at that time. This is one of the regulatory principles. So my Guru Maharaj was asked, but I want to pay the obeisances. So what should I do? If I break the regulatory principle, will I not become dear to Krishna? That regulatory principle? So my Guru Maharaj said, bhakti is a function of the heart. Krishna is Bhavagrahi Janardana. So yes, there are regulatory principles, but the heart should take over. So, but Krishna is sitting in the heart. You will get the information that, am I breaking, let's say drinking coffee, for example. Krishna is sitting in the heart. What is there? Taste a little, na? Taste. So that breaking is not the same as paying obeisances when the deities are sleeping just because I've come to see the heart. Are you getting the difference, Mataji?
No, Mataji. I'm not.
Okay.
Mataji, one reason could be, hello, yes. Mataji.
Yes, Prabhu.
Hello, Mataji. One reason could be that because we are wearing that kantil close to our kant.
Yes.
So kant is like a vocal cord. When we say Krishna's name through the vocal cord,
yes,
it automatically activates the power of the kanti.
Yes. Yes.
No, but she's not asking about Kanti. She's asking about the chanting.
Regarding name bead.
Beads. Do you have tulsi beads?
Yes, I have tulsi beads.
That's fine. It's fine, Mataji. Whatever you have, just okay. Chant the whole. Pray to Tulsi Maharani to put you on the highest platform.
Okay, then I'll find out the name bead in between.
No, you find out how you will chant 16 rounds. Don't find out name bead.
We have to chant 16 rounds with Nimbid.
Okay, I'll tell you the recommendation again. The recommendation is, it's a recommendation, it's a guideline. It's not like it's imposed. Yeah. That if someone is chanting less than 16 rounds, then yes, the recommendation is to chant on the Nimbids. But it's a recommendation. And if you don't have anything and all you have is a Tulsi bead, oh, if you will chant on Tulsi bead just one round that you're doing, will you become offensive? No.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay, Mataji, understood. But you told Tulsi is a very pure devotee, so we are going everything through Tulsi. But what for neem? Neem?
No, that is only until you reach the prescribed number of rounds given by Srila Prabhupada. Don't get caught up in the rituals. You are getting caught up in the rituals, Mataji. I am telling you, it's fine. The first day I went to temple, I was not chanting 16 rounds. I was not even chanting. But Prabhu handed me Tulsi beads because that's all what was available in the temple at that time. So I directly started chanting on Tulsi beads, one round, half a round, three rounds. So it's fine. I am, did I not become Krishna conscious? No.
Mataji, I want to share my personal experience, Mataji.
Yeah, yes. But Prabhu, can we give stage to Aishwarya? Because I don't want people to leave. I am seeing number going down. And then, okay. Yes.
Mataji, I wanted to ask one question.
Yeah, Prabhu, please wait. Aishwarya has come to announce something. Let's all hear her out.
Yeah, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. I think I need to share the screen if you gave me the permission.
Yeah. You are co-host. Go ahead.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Okay, so Hare Krishna, everybody. It's just a small presentation about the children's program ISKCON Mangalore is conducting about. So I just want to go a quick slideshow about it. Okay, so basically, Radha Govind Temple ISKCON Mangalore is conducting, the Bhagavad Gita course for 18 days for adults as well as children's. And we have a new batch starting from November 2nd. So basically guided by Namanishta Prabhu, is temple president, and obviously Prem Kishori Mataji, she's my Shiksha Guru. And so the children's program, the new batch is starting from November 2nd. And we have it's for 18 days. So we have a Bhagavad Gita overview, sloka recitation, and interactive sessions Okay, and there is some activities like artworks for kids and storytelling about the different pastimes of Krishna and some role play by some senior devotees and life lessons. So basically just to make them interested in the Gita, and this is the interactive sessions, how we go, and kids are really inquisitive to know about Krishna. And these are some of the artworks which they did, and this really encourage other children to take up drawing. And there's some role play that is done by some senior devotees about the three modes of material nature so that they can actually grasp what it is. And some assignments are given about the stories of, to write about the story or pastimes of Krishna and his devotees so that they get close to Krishna. And then the chanting and all is going on. There's some life lessons like Gigo concept, like garbage in, garbage out, good in, good out. So like some basic life lessons from Gita. And so please take advantage of the session. You all also join for the November batch. Ask your friends to join, especially your children also to join the session. And we have different WhatsApp group that will be forwarded to you. So thank you so much. Thank you, Mataji, for giving this opportunity. And hope you will take advantage of this session. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Oh, he's our kids teacher. He's amazing. Thank you, Aishwarya.
Revati wants to join advanced study also. Did you tell them, Mataji, Aishwarya Mataji?
Yes, the Bhaktivinoda.
You didn't mention that. That also mentioned, Mataji. Yeah.
But
yeah.
I need to discuss with Prem Kishori Mataji and okay. Then let all know about it.
Okay.
Because I think, Mataji, they should undergo Bhagavad Gita first, right? The 18 days.
You mean the value of education, the Bhakti Vriksha for kids? We can talk offline.
Okay. Yes. Yes, Mataji. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Okay. Kartik Prabhu, please go ahead. And
yes, Mataji. Quickly, I just want to share my experience. When I joined in August batch, I was not chanting anything. I don't know what is chanting, but slowly. But the 16 rounds was little difficult for me to start with. So I was really not sure whether I'll be able to chant. So currently, by Krishna's grace, what I tried to do is like splitting up for every hour, one round of chanting per hour. So in that way, I'm trying to accommodate 16 rounds a day. So every hour, I'm trying to chant one round so that my mind is accepting, okay, I'm not overloaded, something kind of thing. So somehow I'm with Krishna's grace, I'm able to chant 16 rounds, Mataji. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Very nice. What a success. And 31st October, Damodar month is starting. So that's Kartik month. It's very auspicious month. We offer ghee lamp to Krishna every evening and we sing Damodar Ashtakam. So we will share the link for all of you to join every evening for the whole month for Radha Govinda and offer ghee lamps from your own homes. Please do it because it's a most merciful month and Krishna fulfills all desires, spiritual or material. Have more spiritual desire or only spiritual desires? Yes, Jayanti Mataji and then Jitesh Prabhu.
Mataji, I'm leaving, Mataji. Thank you so much.
Question left unanswered?
No, Mataji.
Thank you, Kalavati Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Sita Mataji, any question left unanswered?
It wasn't regarding chapter, Mataji, but in regards to prescribed, like they Mataji asked if we should do chanting first or yoga first. I don't do the yoga, so I'm not sure how to answer that question. You know, yogasanas.
Yeah. But who asked this question? Is she still here?
Yes, ma'am. Hare Krishna, ma'am. Mani Singh here. It was really, because I do yogasana and pranayama daily. So I was confused whether to finish that up first and then do the chanting, or if chanting should be the first, then I should do that.
So
not
I
sure.
Have, she's an orthodontist in India. She also does this yoga. So what I can connect you to her and you can ask what she does. But she chants first and then does yoga. I don't think there is a difference, but just manage your time. The priority has to be given to chanting. Just manage your time. It's very individual approach. There is no hard and fast written rule. Rekha chants first and then does yoga. That's what she does.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, so you can see.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay, Hare Krishna. Mataji, I'll come back to you at the end again. I just want to address. I know you're not satisfied yet. And I don't want to leave you either. Yes, Mataji.
Mataji, in today's chapter, you gave detailed the thing about modes, different modes of activity one has to do, and you asked us to analyze ourselves, right? Goodness or passion or ignorance, which plane we are in. And most of it, I can speak for myself, most of this I'm in ignorance or passion, on and off fluctuating with goodness, because if I know it is goodness also, it is only in the theoretical level. So if we are not reaching that stage, is there any sin? For example, watching a movie, I can't control watching the movie for some time, and eating outside, we need a break, and we say that this is an often statement. We say we need a break and we purchase outside food. Like small things, runs between passion and ignorance. But I know that it is not good. It is goodness. I have to reach there. But doing in passion and ignorance right now is a sinful act, or how to go to goodness?
Yes, Mataji, thank you for being honest. It's not easy to be honest in public platform. Thank you for being sincere. And the very fact that you are now contemplating is a fact that you're going to be okay. Because some people don't even think that whatever they're doing is, most of the people, is either good or bad. So I can only give you one treatment, and that is chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra attentively, 16 rounds every day, and your life will fall in place. Then you will not be asking. When I started Krishna Consciousness 18 years ago, I used to drink coffee. And I used to like it. South India, so tasty coffee there. Na? Mangalore had such nice, tasty coffee. And Prabhu used to say this to us, Namanishta Prabhu, these regulative principles again and again and again. So when I started chanting, my guilt was like up to the neck. Oh my God. So I remember I used to bring a cup full of coffee to my room. And while studying, I used to put this cup, let's say this is coffee cup, in front of me. And I used to look at it, drink. So I did all those things, and then sometimes I used to drink also, but I used to talk to the cup, drink. So I used to tell, and then I used to call Namanishta Prabhu, I don't think I can face you anymore. Why? What did you do? Because I drank coffee. He used to laugh. He's so merciful. He used to laugh. He said, that's fine. I mean, that's fine. Don't punish yourself. I'm telling you what Prabhu told me. Just follow the process and give yourself time. The Rome was not built in one day. Just follow the process first. If it is still not working, then we have to work in another direction. First thing is follow the process. Or do what I did. Because I was able to give up with that dialogue with the cup of coffee. Drink. You do. But I used to chant, Mataji. I used to chant from 4 a.m. to 6 a.m. every day, and 7 a.m. mess used to open in the hostel, and I used to bring every day, put it in front of me. I think chanting first gave me the strength. So first thing you do in the early morning is chant. Just chant. And slowly it will work out. Okay? There's no magic. You don't have to go to a rehab to give up rehabilitation center to give up coffee. Automatically Krishna will give you higher taste. Everything will fall in place. Oh, we used to go every weekend to eat in a restaurant in Mangalore. And we used to wait. And after I tasted Krishna Prasadam, oh my God. I know we need break. So, but then there are Govindas, no? In temples, there are restaurants called Govindas. Our Sunday love feast is free for everyone. So when it opens up, just go every Sunday, make it a point to go to a temple near you, at least every Sunday. So you have a break every Sunday. Okay, chant, Mataji. Just chant. This okay, all Mataji. Will go.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Mataji.
After hearing this, only the guilty feeling, how to reduce the guilt feeling is also one of the important questions.
Yeah. That's there. It's going because when we chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, we come face to face with our shortcomings. Every day, now also 18 years I'm chanting, every day I come face to face. And then I feel, oh my God, I'm so bad. So the guilt is just make it as a goal that, okay, I need to get rid of the guilt, not live with the guilt. You need devotees. You're such a wonderful person. You attended 18 days. How many people are able to give 18 days continuously? I know when I started this class first day, there were 600 people, more than 600. And I'm ending with less than one third. You think it's easy to go through what you went through? So that's already a worth congratulating thing. And focus on what you're going to do. I write down every day on my whiteboard in the house, what am I going to do for Krishna? And I look at it again and again. And my daughter checks it. Mom, did you do this? Did you do this? Did you do this? So have something objective in front.
Okay? Very practical, Mataji. Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Thanks. Thank you so much for this 18 days insight.
The pleasure is all mine. So, but keep association, because without association, we feel lonely. And why do you have to feel lonely?
Yes, no ma- yes, Mataji. I enrolled already in the detailed class.
Oh, okay. Good. Thank you.
Thank you, Mataji. Thank you,
Hari. Lata, Roshan, was there any question left unanswered? Roshan? Roshan, Hare Krishna. Okay, he'll unmute whenever he can. Lata Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hello. Mataji, I just needed to know more about prasadams offered to Krishna. That is, do we offer every food made, means you know, the whole day, or is it like normally the prasadam is, you know, the first early in the morning, you know, otherwise normally we offer prasadams. So this is like a little confusion, you know.
So you want to become, how much Krishnaized do you want to become? Do you want to become only half? You want to become 30%, 80%? How much do you want to become?
No, 100%.
So then you're 100%. So okay. We can, Krishna can eat the whole universe. You know, Jagannath temple in Puri, right. They offer 56 of items every day. Chappan bhog.
Okay.
Every day. So Prabhupada was calculating in one lecture, 56 items in 24 hours means a cook will need to, if there is only one cook, for example, you are cooking 56 items every day. That means that you're going to be cooking practically 3-4 items every hour, because if you, at the end you will get tired, you may not be able to cook 3-4 at a time. So Krishna can eat the whole Jagannath. He's the Lord. Okay. We offer everything we eat or drink.
Yeah, I got that. But what I have a constraint is, you know, when you live with a family, you know, who are yet to develop this. Like right now, I have got this knowledge and I've understood it. So it's easier for me to practice it alone. But when you prepare it for the family, so, you know,
Are you adding garlic? Is that what you're saying?
Yes, some would. But right now, I have started abstaining from it. So, I'm a little confused as to how to handle it and how, you know, you suddenly cannot make your family change it, you know, all of single day and all those things.
You need to share. That's why we have a group and we decided we're going to share. I never knew how to make calzones, quiche. Exotic dishes that I make now, so that the children's family's tongue is satisfied and Krishna gone.
Right.
Before you add onion garlic, let's say you're making a dal. You're putting in seasoning. Take the dal out before you add all that and offer Krishna with jeera and ghee. You know, just simple. And then mix it. Everything else, so it becomes
for the past few days I'm not even touching it, so you know I'm trying to, you know, just think that you know, will they be able to, like, you know, handle it every, like, you know, throughout the week or something like that. Yeah, 1-2 days they may just ignore it and they may not say anything, you know. I've also searched out for Vaishnav recipes and all those things, so I think that can help, you know. But what my question here was, every food should be offered, right? Like a morning you make a breakfast, that also should be offered. Afternoon you make enough, you know, lunch, that also should be offered. Is that the way? That is my core question.
Yes. Morning breakfast, afternoon lunch. I don't cook 3-4 times and I cook maybe 3 times a day. So whatever we do, yes. Yes, but then don't worry if you're not able to do something and pray to Krishna. And will that day come? I mean, I will not eat anything other than what you eat or what you leave.
Right. And where do we get the 64 regulative rules, like, you know, regulation rules, whatever, you know. Right now you're talking about prasadams and other things, but there may be many things, you know. Where do we get those?
Nectar of devotion, Srila Rupa Goswami lists. The rules, one should not wear blue and red clothes, color clothes in front of the deities. One should not sit on the bare floor. There should always be a mat. One should not talk in front of the deities. One should not laugh in front. There are so many rules given.
Right.
Okay. Nectar of Devotion, Mataji. I'll show you the book. Nectar of Devotion is... you're looking at my screen?
Yes.
The first part of Nectar of Devotion is about... Nectar of Devotion has four parts. First part is about the regulative principles or Vidhi Bhakti. Nectar of Krishna. Where is the book? Here. So see, in the eligibility, devotion service, purity, evidence, how to discharge devotion service and offenses to be avoided. This chapter 8 and chapter 9. So these two chapters talk about 64 offenses.
Okay. Thank you, Mataji.
Yeah, Krishna. Okay, Amrudha, oh, that was Amrudha Mataji. Rajani Mataji, Rajani Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Thank you and feel so blessed to be a part of this session all the 18 days. Although yesterday and today I've been a bit late in joining because of the festive celebrations, but I have made it to the session although. And I'm keenly waiting for the YouTube recordings to watch the first bits, which I have missed, you know, like 15 to 20 minutes. And thank you very much for this. It's so enlightening and got to know many facts, which probably, you know, is going to lead towards the path of Krishna. I think so. I hope so. And I've started my journey. I only started knowing many facts, which I wasn't aware of. And thank you so much, first of all. And secondly, coming to the, you know, the situations like this at the present, where, you know, it's difficult to go to temples and pray. So when we consider temple as a pious place or as an abode of sanctity, is it the same, you know, when we pray, when we are praying at home, do we get the same kind of vibes? I know it makes a difference going to the temple, but, you know, sometimes like these situations in Corona, you can't go to the temple all the time. So just sitting at home and praying, is that's fine, right? As long as you chant and have, obviously, when we are saying that God is within you in your heart, it should reach. So is there any specific, I don't know how to take it now, because I feel, you know, suddenly when this Corona started, I was saying God has closed the temple's door, you know, and people were like, you know, I was like, I don't know what's happening. When the temples were closed, I was kind of, what's happening? Only when the temples closed, not when the other. But then when I started, of course, I'm doing it at home. But then there was the question in my mind, why, what's happening? Why is the temple door being closed? So I don't know how to take it.
Yes, yes, I also miss, and we are used to going to Gitanagari every two weekends a month. We just go and live there with the devotees for 2-3 days. We just go. So it is very hard on me also. I am empathizing with you. It's very, very hard. Every day I miss the devotees so much. I miss devotees more than anyone. It's so nice to look at their bright faces and to look at the practice. And the Gita Nagari I showed in the beginning of the class, that's where we go. It's a very beautiful place. Yes, but as far as your Krishna consciousness is, let's take example of Draupadi. It is written in that incident. So when Draupadi, they were trying to disrobe Draupadi, she was first of all holding back, you know, she was asking elders of the family, she was trying to do it herself. But when she recognized that it's not possible, all these people are useless, they cannot, who can? Krishna. So she gave up her anxiety and served Krishna with all her heart. Krishna gave more protection. So when we get Vipralambha Bhav, this is called Vipralambha, serving Krishna in separation is actually more intense than serving Krishna face to face. And Krishna, it's not easy also. I'm not at that level where I can serve Krishna Vipralambha Bhav and say, oh, I am in separation. I need I need devotees. I need to go and interact and talk to them, eat with them, serve the deities, go on the altar. I just enjoy all that thing. So I get that. But right now, serve Krishna in lot of separation. Krishna, every day I'm missing. Every moment I'm missing. When will this get over? When will I come? When will that day come? When will that day come? So you're thinking now you're in samadhi. So it's nice. There is no misfortune in any situation in serving Krishna. There's no misfortune. I will give you one more example. My Guru Maharaj gives this example from Christian church. There was a very big saint, Saint Francis. This Saint Francis, you're in UK, right? So Saint Francis is very famous there also. So Saint Francis actually in his earlier life was a war veteran. Was in the army. He fought many wars and then he got fed up looking at the bloodshed and then he started going towards the God. So when Saint Francis was sitting with his brothers, in Christian church they called brothers, like we call Mataji Prabhuji, like that they call brothers and sisters. So he was sitting with his brothers and he asked them, what is it that you really enjoy in devotional service? And what is it that you really enjoy? I guess if I ask this question in this class, I will get different answers. Someone enjoys eating prasadam. Someone enjoys sitting with devotees. Someone enjoys dancing. Someone enjoys harinam. Someone enjoys bhagavatam class, bhagavad gita, like that. Someone enjoys dressing the deities, looking at the deities, aarti to the deities. Like different people will have different inclinations. So he got the same answers from them. And then everyone asked him, so what is your verdict? So he said this. He said, let's say that you are in the middle of nowhere and it's a snowy night and it's a very snow-filled mountain and it's very cold. You don't have any food, any shelter, any money. You're alone and you are shivering in severe cold. And then you see this light from very far away that there is this place called bed and breakfast. So you think that, you know, thank God, like I'm going to enter this bed and breakfast motel or hotel. And I will rest in a warm room, cozy room, and I'll get some food and some warm drink. So thank God. So then you go there. You somehow make it over there. He kept on telling them. You knock at the door and the person comes out. And comes out with a big stick and starts beating you up. Then how dare you knock? So, and then you're really not left with anything. So you're really separated from everyone. And that time you have nothing else left other than God. That is the highest enjoyment. So that I'm not saying copy that. I'm not saying do that now. But in this present day world where we are, the verdict is the enjoyment, develop more intense surrender. More intense surrender. I can't wait. So now when you will go back to temple after this is over, your devotion is going to be a thousandfold better than when you were taking it for granted and going every week. I know when I will go back to temple and I will jump onto the deity worship. When I was living with the devotees for 4 months and I got Gayatri, I got Brahminical initiation and then I was put on the altar and I was getting trained how to worship the deities. After some days, my back was hurting. Oh my God. But after coming back home and now I can't wait. Now I'm like, oh my God, I have to get back. Enough is enough. Okay. Yes. I don't know if I answered your question.
Yes, you have, Mataji. Thank you. Thank you.
Sita Mataji, you have to leave.
Yes, Mataji, thank you so much for another amazing 18 days. So I tell everybody in my break room, you know, because you are my sadhu sangha. Coming to this class is trying to keep my, that's my association because I'm a brand new student. So at least that's the listening process, right? And everybody wants to jump from zero to 1,000. What I have learned is take baby steps and be happy with the small successes you've achieved.
Very nice. That is why you're very sincere. Yes, very nice. Thank you, Sita Mataji. Thank you
Hare
for
Krishna, Mataji.
These days also. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. And Rajni Mataji, thank you for your nice words, my glorification. I hope I pray Krishna and Prabhupada to purify your life and decorate it with so much Krishna consciousness and happiness.
Thank you so much, Mataji. That means a lot, actually. And are your classes, I have enrolled for the advanced course. Are you going to run those discourses as well? Or
Prabhu is running too. Prabhu is doing and I'm also doing. Prabhu is more he's more advanced. He's taking more classes than I can give. So either one of us. I don't know what did you enroll in. I am not having any enrollment. I just opened up a WhatsApp group and shared the links. Okay. But we are going to have first class on Thursday. So, Mataji, go to Prabhu's class. Now, Anishtha Prabhu's life-changing experience. His words are more powerful because his practice is more intense. You know, there's so many doctors in this room, right? Dr. is a heart surgeon and Shivaram Prabhu, I don't know if he's still here. He was there yesterday.
Yeah, Mataji, yeah.
Hare Krishna. So he's also new, another devotee. So he's a surgeon of a GI surgeon. So very big surgeons. Why their practice is going to be so authentic? Because their training is so intense. Like that, Mr. Prabhu's his dedication and surrender is more intense than mine. So if you hear him, you will have more purification. So go to him.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, Hare Krishna. Okay.
Is there any recordings that had
Yes, is there any recording of what? Dr. Pradnya, yes, Mataji, recording of?
You know the recordings which are pending. I hope Karthik Prabhu will be uploading it very soon. I think till 15th chapter I saw, 16th, 17th and 18th has not been done in the YouTube.
Yeah, 16th, 17th I uploaded yesterday. It is available. 18th today I will upload.
No, that's fine. 16th, 17th probably I've noted it earlier, then I didn't see
everything. Everything will be there for you, Mataji. Don't worry.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Will these video recordings be available even after a few days of this course getting?
Yeah. Available always. We are not going to channel. Yeah. Dr. Pradeep, you have been waiting a long time. Where are you?
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Dr. Pradnya. Yes, Mataji.
Thank you so much for such a wonderful session for 18 days.
Thank you.
And, I am speechless today. I don't know, but tears are floating in my eyes.
They were floating in my eyes too, but I controlled. I took it back.
Yeah.
Every time we finish a session because it gets so much enjoyment, right? There's so much enjoyment. I also
I'm unable to enroll myself in Teachables since so many days. There may be some technical issue, but I even get the contact number.
Oh, so Teachable. Mataji, what is happening? You need to have an email ID and a password. That's it.
I tried many times since many days. I'm trying, but
with different
there
is no limit to the number of students that can come. There is no limit, so there is not like okay, we have met the limit that only these many accounts can be opened. I don't know what the problem is. You email it to me. I will connect you to the technical team.
I'll send an email to you, Mataji.
Okay, now I have to reply to so many emails and I'm so bad. I will send it back. I will reply today. Okay?
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. I have a question left.
Yes. Yes, Prabhu, one second. Dr. Paddy wanted to say something and I very conveniently suppressed his voice. Yes, Paddy, Dr. Paddy.
Yeah, it's very nice to hear all these days. Actually, I was listening for two sessions. In the first session, I got so much attached to this thing again. I, along with my wife, and we both together enjoying. And I'm really grateful with the way you are dedicatedly and very effortlessly explaining. And with so much patience, and from the night, from 3 o'clock, you are getting up and telling all these things. It's becoming a hard to believe for all of us you are taking so hard work. And definitely you have enlightened us, whatever knowledge I had, and all these the structured way how you are telling and with your difference, it is really changed our heart. And definitely we'll be more into the chanting, and we'll be getting more blessed of Lord Krishna. And we hope Krishna's blessing will be there with you all the time. As in today's the canto in 68 and 69, what Lord Krishna has told, you are preaching the Krishna consciousness so effortlessly and delicately, and the blessing will be there with you and your family all the time. Okay, thank you, Mataji.
Dr. Buddy, a little bit about Dr. Buddy. I came to know about him last session. And he's a cardiothoracic surgeon, and he was joining our classes in the, in the hospital, sitting in the cardiac ICU. We all geared up with his personal protective equipment, with wearing N95, wearing headgear, wearing the jumpsuit, the protective suit, and he's hearing Bhagavad Gita, my class. I could not believe. I asked him many times, Dr. Buddy, why are you coming to my class? What is it that you're getting? And then he said, I'm getting my wife also. I'm getting my daughter also. And his wife is my good friend now. So I'm very indebted, and your enthusiasm is very, very infectious. You're a role model for the society. You're a leader in any way because you help very complex people. I understand completely. So thank you for your participation, and thank you for your blessings. Okay, Jitesh.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. First of all, thank you for rendering Gita ji so nicely to us. My question was that about this spiritual master. How do we define a spiritual master in today's times? Because at the end of the day, even they are cleansing their karmas with us.
That's a material vision. So to be a devotee, we have to be a devotee. Let's say, remember that 15th chapter, 10th verse, Jnana Chakshushaha, we have to have eyes of knowledge. We cannot look at devotion, devotee in another human being if I am not a devotee. It's not. I'll give you an example. Let's say that there are so many doctors in this class. So when someone goes to them, with some problem, they will have a different vision, right, Prabhu? Jitesh Prabhu?
Yeah.
They will have a different vision than anyone else whose eyes are not trained in that knowledge. So that way, we have to, we see impurity because the impurity is within me.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that the other person is impure. Actually, the world is made by Krishna, and there is nothing which is separated from Krishna. We are thinking it is separated because I am separated.
Mm-hmm.
Once you connect yourself back to Krishna, the things will fall in place.
Mm-hmm.
So the doubt that you're having will become asakti. Shraddha will become asakti, attachment. So there are, of course, I agree with you that there are more cheaters than real people. I agree. Because that's the influence of
Yeah, most of them.
But why are there more cheaters? Really, Prabhupada asks this. Why are there so many cheaters? Because people want to be cheated. They want something other than Krishna. So people are there. Okay, I will give you dust converting into sand, converted into gold. People want that. So it's time to go more inward and ask, what do I want? What am I looking for? Am I looking for Krishna, or am I looking for the relief from some temporary misery and then I forget God? What is it that I want?
There has to be a spiritual connect, I guess.
You will find a spiritual master. That's another level. But first thing that I'm seeing in you is not a fault. I'm seeing that you are full of doubts. And the doubts can only be going away by regulated practice.
Mm-hmm.
Once that doubt is over, then the next level comes for search for the spiritual master. That's the next level.
Mm-hmm.
First, you have to make your Shraddha strong. So I will ask you to read something right now, but let me take other question also. Okay, Prabhu, just wait. I'm pulling up an article for you to read. And then I will take Mahati's question. Mahati, please go ahead.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Krishna.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
I would like to thank you Mataji for teaching such a wonderful teaching. It was all these 18 days. It was very much interesting and we don't know what to do from tomorrow. You have completed 18 days. We were adjusted to this timing to listen to classes.
Nothing left to do.
Every day without fail. But from tomorrow, what to do from 3 p.m. again?
And Hare Krishna. And come back.
And Mataji, I wanted to know, you had said that listen to Prabhu's classes for advanced teaching. But timings, I wanted to know, Mataji, and the link to join the group.
Yes, I will share in the WhatsApp groups.
It is okay. Not shared in the group, Mataji.
I have to share to avoid confusion because last batch, everybody yes, shared. Mataji. There's a lot of chaos. So Prabhu told me it has to come from me. So I got all the information. So I will share today. Okay.
Yes, Mataji. Thank you, Mataji, once again.
Hare Krishna. Thank you for your participation and your marvelous.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Melodious chanting of verses I'm going to miss.
Hello, Mataji.
Your chanting is so melodious, the verses.
Yes, yes Mataji. Thank you.
Geeta, Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji, it was really very nice hearing you so many days, 18 days was very good. But in this lockdown, I actually made this process very good for me. Actually, my son who is there in this session along with me, Rohit, so he was already into Krishna consciousness before I could come. So last year he had already joined and he had made me learn all this before these classes began. So I was already started reading Bhagavad Gita a little bit, but with your sessions, it gave me more clarity and more clarity to many verses. And I should say I have already left my non-veg and everything very first of all, I was shocked with seeing my son. Like, he was such a hard eater for non-veg and he had left. And seeing him, I was shocked and even I too left. And I feel now so much purified. And your session was so good, so good, so good. And I should say, truthfully, I was waiting for your classes every day. And as everyone said, it is very difficult from tomorrow. 3 o'clock, we were waiting. Yes, my class will start, And from tomorrow, of course, I'm doing my only one round of chanting. But I feel very nice and good. If I feel I'm late, if I'm not doing, I feel I have missed it. But I do every day, no doubt about it. And sometime if I feel low, I just take one of the chapters of Bhagavad Gita and I read. I feel very peace after that.
That's good.
I'll be definitely continuing and also continuing with my detailed classes, which we'll be sharing again today. And I like the way you say no. So I love that. And if I feel something is wrong somewhere with anyone or even at my home or anywhere outside, I'll definitely say the same way you say no. I just love that. Of course, you have a loving
Hare family. Krishna Masaji. I also support you. The way you say no is contagious.
Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's really contagious.
God bless your family. And
that is your signature, Mataji. Prem Kishore Mataji signatures.
Yes, actually. And tomorrow is my birthday. Please bless me, Mataji. I will really love to hear you again and again. Thank you, Mataji.
Person every day. Listen to the building. I scolded so much today. So thank you so much for talking all my shortcomings.
Thank you.
Hi Krishna. Amrita Mataji.
Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
I have texted you. Thanks for the 18 days journey with you. I'm very, very happy with you and I'm going to continue with the advanced study of Gita. Thank you very much, Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you.
I have texted you.
I will see my text. I haven't seen my
phone yet.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Krishna.
Hare Krishna, I wanted to thank you. Sindhu here.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, it was very...
Hare Krishna, Mataji, thank you very much.
Thank you. Hare Krishna, welcome.
It was a very good journey for 18 days, but I'm not going to go. I'm here to stay. So I'm just saying thank you for your insightful session.
Thank you, Mataji, for your participation, for your emails, one-liners. I like emails, one-liners. My answers are so easier. Thank you.
Thank you for all the responses. I'm also a teacher, so I know how difficult it is.